nigga, let's be honest. If we were still in the mixtape era, you probably wouldn't get your hands on beef tracks because they were in some hood on some corner store that you had to walk in this bitch and get it, except when LimeWire came around. But at one point in time, you had to go in the grimiest spot to get a beef, get a diss track. Because diss tracks wasn't made by the labels. It was made by these niggas out of their own pocket over an instrumental that they didn't have clearance for, that they had to drop on a Who Kid mixtape or a fucking Clue mixtape or DJ Big Mike mixtape. And you had to go to the hood to get these mixtapes.
They different
now, y'all niggas feel comfortable. Y'all getting on you.
But I just know that they lying like a motherfucker.
They've been lying. They've been lying since the creation of lies. Once, yo, the first nigga who knew how to lie was like, got him. And he passed that shit down. I'm telling you, because
pass the lies down is crazy.
Once they figure out, okay, we could just tell them whatever during the educational system. We could tell them whatever the fuck we want. And and then they knew that you was just gonna continue to believe it no matter what. It don't matter what you think you know. You'll never know the truth. We could be being watched right now. Your life could just be to be watched and studied, or the aliens could be siphoning your energy right now, and that's the only reason why we're here, is just to be siphoned. You don't know.
Or this can be a computer simulation like the Matrix, and we stuck in this bitch.
That's kind of where I was going. I mean, y'all want to have that conversation, but I had that conversation.
I was getting there. Talking about was beef. Go ahead. Go ahead. Break it down to me. Let me explain. Explain to me.
I mean, I believe in Jesus Christ, so I'm gonna put that there. You know what I'm saying? But what I'm saying is you wouldn't know if we were being watched or being or in a simulation. You wouldn't know. I mean, there's been what they call proof and like coding within certain like water and stuff like that. There's proof. But what can you do with the proof that they tell you that they get, whoever they is? You can't do shit. So you'll never know. So just live your life the best way you can. That's it.
Did you want to know? Like you think your puny brain could handle if you actually...
No. Just imagine if you
your mind
just,
can fathom it.
No. Just imagine if just you imagine were told the truth and your brain goes unlocks. You somebody actually that. Shows you what's going on, and your brain unlocks.
No, because your brain won't unlock. Your brain will sit at the level that it is right now, unless there's secret things that happens when you know that there is a matrix. But at your current state, the reason why it's unfathomable is because you are at a state where you're at, that's all you can handle. Here, you know, like if somebody told you right now that aliens walk around among us, which they probably do, walk among us right now, and that they have something on their face where you as a human being, you cannot see through it. All you see is the mask, right? And somebody proved that to you, you would go crazy, because it also puts you on a path to where how many people are these aliens? How many, like, what are they here to do? Why don't we know? What, like, it'll be so much it'll drive you crazy and you could not process it all because your mind is a computer.
Yeah, but also when you upgrade your memory. You upgrade your hard drive.
Your how are you doing games, that?
Yeah, listen, like I said, you don't know what happens. So that's why they say you only use what 10% of your brain. So imagine,
hey, nigga, you're referring to
the scientists is who say it. They
no.
Who the fuck came up with the who came up with the percentage of 10%? You know, somebody said equating find out the truth is the equivalent to seeing a bear. A bear close to you in the wild. your brain wouldn't be able to process what the fucking do that you're in this close vicinity to this fucking bear that is right there and there's nothing protecting you from it. Your brain will fucking go fucking ape shit. It'd be that's the equivalent of fucking seeing the fucking... No, it's the equivalent of seeing the spaceship drop out of his...
I saw a nigga kick a bear out of his yard, so I can't really say that.
Yeah, okay. You personally seen a fucking 900-pound
and the bear swiped him. Bear swiped him, and he was like, hey, you get out of here right now, bear. Yeah. This dude's not for you.
Oh, he's a crazy white dude.
You didn't see that video?
But I'm saying, y'all, seeing a bear in the wild, 10 feet from you, that it can attack you, your brain wouldn't know what to process, what to do. You will fucking freak out. Oh, shit. That's the same as you. This ship is fucking friendly. If that bitch is about to annihilate this world to do whatever, it's the same thing with that bear. You don't know if that bear is full, hungry, or is ready to maul you, or just gonna walk the fuck off.
Yeah, but you can't say that for everybody because people train their brains to do certain shit to be ready for certain things. So if you actually believe in a situation like that, and wholeheartedly you believe that, all right, there's aliens walking around amongst us and they have this, and you believe that, and somebody brings that to your attention and then proves it, then you don't seem crazy anymore to yourself. You know what I'm saying? Now you actually know the truth.
You might take different steps to try to prove it.
If they seen a fucking spaceship drop out of the sky, just fucking come. These people that have been searching for spaceships all their fucking life, and now everybody's seeing it. You don't know. They don't know what type time that fucking spaceship is on. They don't know if that shit's on some fucking We Come in Peace or some Independence Day shit. Well, you can't. You will freak the fuck out. You will be like, oh my gosh. Yes, I have proof. But is this shit about to kill me because it exposed itself? Like, you don't know what type of time that shit is on.
It's two different schools of thought. The bear thing is survival. That's a different part of your brain, bro. Seeing a spaceship, the first thing you're not going to go to is survival because you don't know if it's a threat. So when you see a spaceship, you know exactly, your brain knows exactly what to do with it.
If I see a fucking spaceship, my first instinct is...
getting the fuck out of Dodge.
Like, yo, I'm getting the fuck as far away from where that shit is, I'm at right now. I don't know.
Until somebody proves otherwise, I need to get up out of here.
Name two different schools of thought. You're not going to stick around, but it's two different schools of thought.
Name anybody that fucking discovered a new land with indigenous people there that they came in peace.
I don't know. I don't know what that's doing. The aliens? Yeah, but you're saying that sitting on the couch.
They're
seeing. All right, go ahead, please.
Seeing an alien and seeing another human being that looks just like you coming on a boat is not the same.
Two different schools of thought.
No,
exactly.
I'm not talking about the aliens looking like us. Get that whole thought process out of here.
That's not what we were saying.
No. Anytime something came from a far away land, when they found and discovered a new land, that they came in peace and wanted to be in harmony with anything. You can't.
What does that have to do with what we're talking about? I need you to make an assimilation.
We are indigenous to this land. Here comes a foreign thing that discovered resources that they want. And they see that their technology or the weaponry they have is far superior to us. You really going to think, how you really think they're going to be like, hey, let's bargain our planet. I'm just saying.
All right.
You're not.
Right.
Okay.
But let's say this, right? Because everything was in comparison to the bear. So understand that's where we're coming. That's where I'm, coming from. Everything was in comparison to that bear. So the bear, the bear is going to do one of three things, right? That's why I said survival kicks in. And no, you don't know exactly what to do off top, but your survival instincts will kick in. And then your body reacts. It's not even really your mind. It's your body. The reason why I say it's different when you see a spaceship is because you will get out of Dodge. You have no idea what that spaceship is going to do. You have no idea if that bitch is going to keep going. right? You have no idea if they got some type of ray that no matter what you do, that shit will suck you up or obliterate you. You don't know what it is because it's foreign. A bear, at least you learned about what a bear does in school. At least you watch some shit on the National Geographic about what a bear does. At least they say, which don't do this, become bigger than the bear. You have thoughts to, yeah, that your mind goes to, that at least your body can react off that. When you see an alien spacecraft, you don't even know how to process what it is. You understand what I'm saying? So to say, oh, they're here to kill us, you don't, you think you're going to do that, but you're sitting on a couch right now. We're all sitting on a couch. You have no fucking clue what the hell you're going to do, like you would when you see a bear.
My mind is
not only that, but when you're comparing it to humans, when you see a when you see a human being who looks like you, your mind also will be like, all right, how am I going to handle this situation? This is a person. This is what I can do. That, you know what I mean? You'll have different thought process that'll make a complete any person who sees another person coming into their land looks just like you, just speaks a different language. You're not immediately going to think, oh, you're coming here to harm me. You're seeing someone who looks like you compared to you seeing something that's extraterrestrial, something you've never seen before. You know what I mean? Don't know what to expect out of it. Now, you know what to expect from people. You know what I'm saying? It's either going to be this way or that way. You know what I mean? Oh, but you don't know what to expect.
Let me ask you a question. I know y'all both seen it. Y'all ever heard of that island where the indigenous people live and people go there to try to convert these people to Christians, and they basically lived off the grid? They don't know anything about technology or anything like that. So seeing people in clothing and different skin or riding a boat that just glides by itself. I know Drake, he probably knows. I'll wait till you get back on. He probably, you
the
know
island of Dr. Moreau.
You know that island that where them indigenous people live?
You was there, right?
Yeah. Right there with you holding hands while you was, I'm not even getting into that. I had a whole
go ahead, man.
But, real shit is an indigenous island where people go to try to convert these people to Christianity. They go to the island, they get killed, they get murdered because these people been living in the bush all the time.
So I know that island. Like,
yeah, when they see a boat coming up, it's all this shit is foreign to them. First thing they go into is fucking attack mode because they kill
you on sight. No, you get killed. Kill you on
Green
sight.
Inferno.
And it's a cannibal. They're cannibals. Also, they get killed and eaten.
And they fucking seeing, like I seen one time I was watching a helicopter fly
delicious
over.
Ass intruder.
Flying over to Amazon, and they discovered a people who've been living in the Amazon all their life. These motherfuckers just shooting arrows at it because they don't know what they're seeing. You talking about seeing people, bro? You just seeing some maybe the aliens come get off the fucking spaceship and look just like us. But when you see this shit come floating out of a fucking sky, you really going to sit there like, oh, let's see if I can shake hands with it? You are immediately, if these motherfuckers came out 10 feet reptilians, you really going to sit there and say, let me see what they got to say?
No one does that. My point being is that, once again, we're only comparing it. We can move on. Please, let's move on to the bear thing. That was a false comparison because, like I said, your body would take over. But what you're saying is you would immediately know what to do. Of course, you're going to run. Of course, you're going to try to seek. But you're not gonna. Them niggas could fucking. All right, let's take the Miami aliens for instance.
I've seen an alligator down.
No. Just let's stick with not animals, sir. Because I don't think you understand that it's a completely different train of thought. The Miami aliens were said to be phasing in and out of reality. Or phasing in and out of, sight, our perceivable sight, phasing in and out, which then you have to say that, okay, if they're not speaking, then let's just assume that they speak telepathically. When a nigga start talking into your motherfucking head, clear as day, you're going to be like, you're going to do the Shaggy and Scooby shit. Do. Yeah, you can, but what if the motherfucker be like, nah, son? Just sit right there. Let me talk to you for a second.
Phase in front of you.
Right. Yeah. You try to run in it. I'm saying that there is a foreign object. I get it. You're saying that people react to other foreign people, and it, nigga, the point is you have more faculties in your brain than those people on that in the bush, right? You have more faculties. There is more to compute, like a computer. So what happens is when you see something like that, your brain is searching to put it. It may be a fraction of time. Your brain is searching to put that in a box.
Today's sponsors are brought to you by Ideas Unlimited. Do you have a birthday party coming up? Maybe a baby shower. Could be a wedding party. School's letting out. Could be a graduation party in mind. Ideas Unlimited has it all, from custom 360 booths with backdrops to a personalized throne chair with centerpieces. You like snacks? Everyone likes snacks, am I right? Get your snacks custom made with your face on it. Ideas Unlimited can do it all and more. Get all your party needs at Ideas Unlimited, your party one-stop shop. You can contact them on Facebook and Instagram. Ideas Unlimited, proud sponsor of the Opinionated Podcast.
You think
and how to
that,
deal with that box.
And how to deal with the box. That's the way brains work.
Yeah, because you have an idea of what you have some sort of idea. If a bear's coming, you're either going to be scared and stuck, and you're going to be like, all right, don't move. Maybe the bear won't come after me. Or you're going to try and run. It's going to be fight or flight at that point. You know what I'm saying? If you see some shit doing some shit that you've never seen done before, period, like you don't, and you don't know how to deal with that scenario, then you're just stuck. And I'm like, what do I do? What do I do? You know what I mean? Like Dre said, that motherfucker phasing in and out in front of you, and then you think you're gonna run away, and motherfucker phase right in front of you.
Nigga, Goku, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and start talking to you telepathically. You might go crazy right then and there.
I will swing. You're gonna go crazy.
On the phasing, the phasing alien, going phase and disappear, and phase inside of you.
Chop a tree down right on that nigga, dog.
Y'all niggas, man. Fuck all this alien shit talk. I'm tired of shit. Done with this shit.
It's fascinating, but
I don't talk about it. Is fascinating.
It's fascinating. Coming around. But I'm just saying, dog. Like Nick.
I swear and everything.
No, but I'm telling you my last alien story. I swore, and I know as a kid I seen the fucking UFO, and it was me, Raheem, Calvin, cousin Rolanda. Who else was out there that night? Yeah, this is my cousin. They was all because we all seen the same thing. We all talk about this story. We all say, yeah, I remember that night. Remember it happened. And I think it was my cousin Rebecca. But we was all out one night playing riding down the street, playing that night as kids. And next thing you know, you see four fucking helicopters chasing this fucking, like, looks like a glowing fucking ball. Like, it's like, fuck it, but it's fucking moving. And these helicopters is on this thing's ass. And you can tell they're fucking military helicopters. It gets over where we at, and the shit stops. And it stopped. The ball of light is bright as fuck. So the four helicopters do a maneuver where they all surround this glowing ball. Nigga, when they surrounded and they thought they have it, this bitch shot the fuck straight up in the fucking air. And just disappeared. The helicopters like hover for a few minutes, and I guess like, yeah, what the fuck? And they just went back to base. All of us as kids is looking at each other in like disbelief, like, yo, what the fuck did we just see? Like, what the fuck was that? Like, right. And we had to ask each other, did we just see what we thought we just saw, or am I going crazy right now? And everybody's like, no, I seen it. That was the first thing. It's five or six of them. We all had to ask each other, like, yo, did you see what we just saw, or are we fucking going crazy? And everybody's like, no, I seen it. Like, right. Where did it go? Like, where did that shit go to? It's like, we fucking scattered after that. But we all had to, we couldn't fathom. Even though I watched this shit happen, if all of us watched this shit happen, and I know they're here with me, my brain still couldn't compute what the fuck I just saw. Correct. And I thought I was going crazy.
Yeah.
I thought I was going crazy. Like, you can have, like, I want to get them on this podcast, but they all say the same thing. Yo, I remember that night. Like, I thought I was just tripping. Or I thought that was something I made up as a kid. I'm like, no, I still remember that shit.
That's a perfect example, though, of how you couldn't decide what was going on mentally compared to if you see a bear 10, 20 feet away from you and your thought process is like, what do I do? I can do this. I could do that.
I'm going to tell you exactly what I would think if a bear was, look, that's why when I was a kid, even now, if a bear was somewhere between me and my friends or family, that's when it pays to be one of the fastest ones there. So I know exactly what I'm doing because one of y'all niggas going to get it. I'm going to be fine.
But it's still like, yo, did we just
see a fucking, nigga loses?
Did we just fucking see a bear? You still like, dude, but fuck it. Let's move on.
Kev, we're talking about what's fast.
I ain't tall too tall to run fast. Nigga.
The bear gets you, buddy.
Nah, it don't. I've been shot at before, nigga. I ain't never moved so fast being shot at, nigga.
A bear with a gun definitely taking
nah,
you.
Nah, bear ain't gonna catch me, nigga. Nigga, when I took off. And at the time, it was me and Calvin we got shot at. That nigga was fast. Calvin was still fast. Calvin's still fast. It was three of us. I was in danger. I was step by step with this nigga because I was able to grab this nigga when the gun went off and put
you
this nigga
ain't
to the
shit. Able to grab Calvin?
I saved my cousin fucking life, nigga. When the nigga shot at
you, grabbed
this nigga
and
slammed him to the fucking ground because I heard the gun go off. And you can hear the BBs like going over top of our heads. Nigga shot twice at us. And you can hear the bullets going over your top of our head. You can see the fucking bushes just getting tore to shit. Like leaves falling on us. Huh?
Somebody had beef
with y'all? No, our dumb ass is playing ding dong ditch, knock knock, zoom zoom, and kick the nigga door off the hinges. Instead of knocking like this, we turned around and fucking mule kicked it and kicked this nigga. Kicked this nigga door off the hinges. This nigga came out with a shotty. He had two in the chamber. And I heard the nigga say, motherfucker. And he said, I heard click, click. When I heard that, I heard boom. I grabbed Calvin, threw this nigga to the ground. It should sound like a million bees going over top of your head. And you could just see the bushes getting tore to shit. Because we like ran in the woods. You could just see like the leaves getting fucked up. Nigga shot again. When he shot the second time, I heard the nigga loading up. When I heard the nigga loading up, I snatched that little nigga. I said, get the fuck up. Hauled ass. Like
how old were y'all?
Like 12 years old. Like 12. I think I was 13.
Calvin was what, 10?
Like 10. I think I was 13. He was like 10. We was young.
Yeah, you stupid ass older cousin about to get him fucking shot. Dumbass.
It was just a wild night, dog. We just had fun. That was like, we were just having so much fun that night doing ding dong dish. We made a white dude, little white kid shit in the bag and set that shit on fire.
All right. Okay.
It was a fun night, dog.
So you didn't have beef on anybody when they shot at you. Let's talk about this. Let's touch on this Drake. Let's touch on this big ass conglomerate of people beefing with each other. Cause I want to say that I was delighted to hear Drake's response, and I want to see all the smoke. I don't want smoke. I just want to see all of it.
Listen, I'm looking at this beef. I think it's long overdue. This is one. I was looking at this shit. This is one opponent Drake can't punch down on because every other nigga he beef with, he always bring up how many more fans he got, how much popular he is, and
not Pusher Not Pusher.
Oh no, Pusher was eating this. Pusher was eating that nigga up. That nigga was killing Pusher. Fucking Jay Prince had to call Pusher like, yo, that's over.
With the hogs.
Yeah, he had to tell the nigga it's over because Pusher got bars. Like that's the thing about I think about Drake. Like I think if you really got bars and you really can spit and you got a little bit of clout, you can air this nigga the fuck out. That's why Ross is probably going to air this nigga the fuck out. That's why Kendrick can air this nigga the fuck out.
Do you think Kendrick like, can air him out? Do you actually? Now, I'm going to hold on. I'm going to put this out there because I know you're going to go in on it. I know you're going to go in on it, and I want you to. Kendrick airing him out. We know lyrically Kendrick has ability to air him out. But Can Kendrick air Drake out?
Yeah. This is why I can air Drake out. Kendrick has a core fucking following. Anytime Kendrick drops, everybody fucks him. Everybody in the rap game fucks Kendrick. That's why they're called him and Drake and J. Cole live with the big three. These are the supposed top dogs. Your Jay-Z, your Nas.
No, I hear you.
And your big, get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Drake usually, when Drake did the thing about Joe Button, when he fucking went at Buttons, he was able to smash Buttons. He's like, all you got is pump it up. So Drake fans, his fans, will, you know, outweigh Joe Button's fans. So they get on, because this is the new age of beef. Ain't about your bars no more. It's like, how many fans you got on social media? Yeah, you only got one song, pump it up. So when Drake, this is Joe Button's social media jumps in, fucking puts as their two cents to it, and it goes crazy. Because just think about, just think about the recent when fucking Kendrick dropped his beef. How many fucking memes and everything did you see? And how many memes did you see when J. Cole apologized? It's like, yo.
That's, I see reactions. More than anything, I see reactions.
But that's where we at.
Videos. Yeah.
So that's why Kendrick can hang with Cole, because what Drake is like, yo, my fan, I got core loyal fans is ready to battle your core loyal fans on social media.
Let me lyrically, can I be more clear? There we go. Bar, that's what I'm talking about.
Lyrically, bar for bar, real hip hop niggas, Drake has no sauce for Kendrick Lamar. Kendrick Lamar, they're trying to say he has a ghostwriter. Drake, we know you have a ghostwriter.
Yeah.
Bar for bar, you're not fucking with Kendrick. All them little punchlines and you singing and all, and your little weird voice that, you know, you
fucking, that sound like hate, but I got you. I'm just waiting for Kendrick to hit. That's a biased account.
I'm just waiting.
Because a nigga can rap.
These like, just be like,
yeah, he can.
You listen to
he
this.
He can rap,
this.
But I'm just waiting for niggas.
Go ahead.
I'm just waiting for the Degrassi shit to come out. I'm waiting for the weird bar. Don't do the bar mitzvah, because then you're going to say you're Jew hate and then all this other shit. We don't need that. But I'm just waiting for these niggas to like, yo, you act tough, but you're really not that tough. You walk around with barrettes and bees in here. I'm waiting for these bars to come.
Well, this is
Kendrick is in the studio cooking it up, and Ross already cooked his ass, in my opinion.
No, Ross ain't cook him. That was a jab. That was a jab. To me, that was a jab. But all right. So let's keep it real. Like me, I was not the biggest Drake fan when he came out. Why? Because I wasn't ready for a nigga to be. I wasn't ready for a guy to be, even though I did like The Best I Ever Had. That was my shit. But I wasn't ready for a guy like that, that was on all accounts soft. Not saying that I could beat him up or something like that, but at the time, on all accounts, yo, you not a street nigga. Like, so talking, rapping street, I didn't get it. As time went on, I said, oh no, that nigga's for real. He's a talented artist. Cool. The thing about Drake, you also got to watch out for him when it comes to shit like this, because the nigga is, he's calculated. That's number one. He's calculated on a diabolical level. He's also very sharp. Like he's not dumb with his pen, right? People respect his pen. Even if he got a ghostwriter, his pen is very respected. The nigga is talented and he's witty as fuck. When I heard this record, I said, oh, because at first I'm ready for him to be like, I'm ready for him to get washed. I'm like, oh, he ain't got nothing for him. No. He sent shots. To me, the wackest bar was Metro, sit your dumb ass down and make some drums. Everything else was, oh, shit. It was witty. And you got to be witty to be able to keep up. Now, I think Kendrick Lamar is super witty. That's the guy with the wits. You have to decipher his fucking bars. You have to decipher them shits. But Drake is good at that shit, too. And them shits land. Drop It, Give Me 50? What, you know what Drop It, Give Me 50 mean?
What?
Okay. He said, when top say drop, you give them 50. They saying that Kendrick, every time that nigga drop, give 50% to Top Dog. So, like, you see what I'm saying? Like, it sounded like some bullshit, like dropping Top Sync, drop, you give him 50. You like, all right, what that mean? He in control of the nigga? No, it's a double entendre. That's just one that I can remember. The nigga is witty, bro. That's
Drake. There you go. But like, just like Pusha say, Drake, you signed to a nigga who signed to a nigga who signed to another nigga.
100%. 100%. Yeah.
That's why he backed the fuck off. Pusha had Drake.
He took the easy way out. Drake took the easy way out.
Oh, he had no, he had nothing. Drake said,
Kev, you want to say anything, buddy?
I'm letting y'all get your shit off before I get into it. Go ahead, okay?
I'm just saying,
you're frozen. That's why I asked.
Pusha did so much investigating. It was like, yo, when he started talking about his son Adonis, I didn't even know Drake had a son. And when he brought that shit out, you got your son, you got a kid by a porn star that you are fucking ashamed of. It was like, ugh. And then when niggas start flying that shit, I was like, ugh. Oh, and then when Jay Prince had to step in and squash that shit, it was like, Drake, you lost that one. You caught a huge L. You can
they said
never,
that he wrote some shit that he didn't want to fucking end up recording. It was supposedly going too far. You know what I'm saying? I heard about some shit like that.
Don't say niggas don't do that because
J. Cole just pretty much backed off for after dropping a diss track. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you know what? That was whack. I'm not gonna do that shit no more. You know what I mean? Apologize and bigged up this nigga. Yeah. What you mean?
What's not going too far? Jay-Z had a line on Nas saying he fucked his baby mom next to his son car seat.
Yo, but peep this. I'm about to fuck your whole mind up. No. You know what happened when Super Ugly came out? You know what happened? Nas won.
Jay took too much of a low blow
because he thought he had an ace in the hole.
Care about
which
that? Yeah,
which that was an ace in the hole. But it didn't like matter when the battle was on.
Yeah.
Listen, this is how Jay lost.
That was a crazy ace in the hole.
Speaking of it, because we just is all beef, because I'm talking about that beef. When your city say, when Ether drop and your city say you lost, Jay didn't fuck with Angie Martinez after that shit dropped. Ether got played, niggas were dropping, flex was dropping bombs on Ether. I remember it. I pulled my car over to listen to Ether. I stopped my car and pull my shit over to the side of the road. No one I can listen while I'm driving because I had to hear Ether. I was a couple of minutes from the crib. I said, no, I got to hear this shit.
That's missing from today's world, by the way, but go ahead. That's missing.
It's like, yo, you
wait. Pulled over?
Yes.
Were we in high school?
No, when Ether dropped in 2002, 2003. I had the Bonneville when Ether dropped.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Kev.
I had Kier. Kier was in the back. I'm going to tell you how I know how Ether dropped. This is how I had Kier in the back. Kier was in the back seat in a car seat. I was coming off the highway near the Super Wild, coming down from where the Super Wild was in Sickleville, riding to my mom's house.
No, you were driving. You just didn't have a Bonneville.
It was I probably had something else.
Yeah, but
I had the Cutlass.
That's what I think you had. There you go.
I pulled the fucking car over, came on Power 99. They just dropping the. You remember they used to drop the bombs too? When they play Ether and I heard that shit, I automatically, my brain said, Jay lost. I'm like, you cannot top this, the track. You can't top the lyrics. You can't top the beat. There's nothing you can do to come back from that. Them niggas had a poll on the radio that night. They involved Hot 90. This is how big this shit was. They involved Hot 97, and Hot 97 was. They said who won? New York City said Nas won the beef. That's what I wish. I'm hoping that this beef turns out to be like that. I pray that it gets that big.
Do you think that them niggas are like spitting venom at each other, like trying to end each other, or is it like light sparring? Because I don't want it to be light sparring. I feel like Kendrick shit was a jab, and I feel like Drake was like, all right, I'm gonna hit you, I'm gonna actually hit you with a hook. I ain't gonna hit you with a jab, I'm gonna hit you with a hook. What you got? This is where we figure out if Kendrick can actually do this shit.
Yes,
he's very talented though.
Because another nigga, we talking about all beef. Another nigga, 50 Cent, was notorious for, he ended Ja Rule's career.
That was different tactics though. It wasn't lyrically.
He tried. Yeah. It was different. He tried.
No, he was doing some real shit, like buying out the whole front row. Yeah, they was in some street shit.
He tried to end D-Block shit. He tried to end D-Block shit. But niggas, 50, I love 50 Cent. That's one of my favorite rappers. But it was like, when he went at the D-Block, it was like, yo, bro, I'm sorry. You one of my favorite rappers, but these niggas hold a special place in my life. Niggas was really picking sides over that beef. I remember I stopped buying G-Unit mixtapes. I'm like, I'm riding with D-Block. Come on, man. Remember, I used to, my car stayed with G-Unit and
you had
D-Block. G-Unit
shit. You had mad G-Unit. Like, that's mad where I really G-Unit started shit. Listening to they shit. It was in your car.
I had mad G-Unit shit. Had mad D-Block shit. But when this nigga picked the beef with D-Block, it was like, yo, man, no. Like, just no. And that's where I'm hoping that this shit goes is like, yo, let's see who ends who career. Let's see who puts... I don't think you can put Drake on the back burner, but I think it will be good to see Kendrick Lamar give Drake a black eye, like, nigga, like, just like Pusha T did. Pusha T gave that nigga a TKO, like, you know what I mean, a technical knockout. He's like, all right, the refs got into it and they stopped the fight. I want to see this nigga get a black eye from Kendrick Lamar get knocked out. I do. That's my feeling.
I'm going to be honest. I think Kendrick got a hard out. I think Kendrick got a hard out because it's too many Drake stands, and we're not deciding this on a mixtape. Now, that's why I was going to put this out. Or post this. I miss mixtapes. You know why? The mixtape made you have to wait for that response. You didn't get it instantly, and you didn't have to see a bunch of kids who don't even know what fucking real rap is. Only go with somebody because they like them better than the other person. Rather than, you know how I feel about Beans and Kiss. I said Beans won. The reason why I said Beans won, we had this conversation before. The reason why I said Beans won, his diss was better. And I love Kiss. Kiss is my favorite rapper. Yes, Beans diss was better.
Yeah.
Oh, that was Beans with Heart. That's Nas when I was thinking about. When Nas says, I'm riding through Philly on the freeway, eating beans fast. When he just went at all of them niggas. He used the same track that Kendrick Lamar just used it. This, the same beat Kendrick Lamar used it. This Drake. Nas used that shit to diss them niggas.
I don't think that was correct, but I fuck with you.
I'm trying to think. Was it that? What did Nas use to diss
Metro
all the niggas
Metro Boomin made the whole beat, that particular one. I don't think that was a sample.
That beat is a sample from Eazy-E.
I was going to say the only thing he sampled was the from around the way. I got to double check.
No.
Let me double check it.
Everybody used that shit. That he freaked the shit out of it. I ain't gonna lie.
I'm gonna leave it there, bro. Because every time we, I'm not trying to do this thing where I prove you wrong. But sometimes it be some shit where I'm like, no, that didn't happen.
I might be wrong.
I might be wrong. But that's not even important. I don't want to do that. Like, that's not where I was going with it. But, yeah.
No, okay. My bad. He didn't use that. Nas used.
It don't even matter.
It doesn't matter, bro.
Oh, whatever. It doesn't matter at this point. But he used. Still mad.
All right. So,
Jesus Christ.
This is a listening experience. But so I said that, and I forget why I even was saying it, but I liked Beans.
These bars were—they hit harder. They were more personal. They were direct shots. It was long as shit.
Then he came with special delivery.
The camp, I mean, the whole state property at that time was amped. Everybody was throwing shit out at the same time, and you felt like Beans was the fucking general of the whole squad. He ran the whole shit. You know what I mean? And when he got in there, he went off
with the kiss,
and then the beat that he did it on Kiss's beat. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
he did the shit on Put Your Hands Up.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? That's the shit that made the ego even crazy. I mean, Beans has always been a lyrical monster, you know what I'm saying? So putting him when he was already in savage mode, and then putting him against an opponent like Jada was probably one of the best things that could happen for hip hop, and also probably one of the most dangerous situations that could have happened in hip hop.
Them niggas was going to
shoot each other. I had a track where it was Kiss and DMX, and it was Kiss going at. This was when Kiss was going at Beans. I don't know on that track that I felt like DMX was taking shots at Jay-Z, but maybe I was bugging.
No, that was a thing.
Yeah, well, there was a situation where
X out Tommy Hunts. You don't remember that?
Yeah.
I think they had a battle where Jay-Z and DMX was battling, and I think DMX had said his shit, and then Jay-Z said his shit, and then once Jay-Z said his shit, he was out, and D was like, "Yo, you're not gonna give me a chance to retort," and you know what I'm saying? Jay-Z left, so they never got to see the actual battle. I think that's kind of like where the beef stemmed from, at least on DMX's part. You know what I mean? You just gonna throw your jabs and dip, and not, you know what I mean? Not let me throw some back.
You're not the king of New York. That's all.
That's the king of New York. That's why I feel like what you just said, Kev, and what Dre said about the mixtape. I think that's what's missing. That's what made beef so fucking. It made it so good because, like you said, you had to get your hands on this shit.
It wasn't
somebody in your ear pumping you with they fucking they shit. Because I remember. Talking to niggas during I remember talking to the twins about the Nas and Jay-Z beef, and I'm like, yo, Nas ate that nigga up on Ether, and we were just in there having a conversation, like going back and forth, arguing. I said, nigga, I got the CD in the car. Better yet, bring the Jay-Z disc. I'm gonna bring the Nas disc. We're gonna play both of them shits and let niggas decide.
That's what's missing right there. The block is missing, nigga. The block is missing. Yeah. That's the fucking name of this whole shit. The block is missing. What's different in beef. If you want me to, hold on. If you want to finish, I'm going to let you finish, but I got to go off. The block is missing in music. You know why? Because that same shit you just said happened around the whole United States. It happened on my block too, bro. It happened on my block too. Not just with the Beans and the Kiss diss. Niggas was on the block arguing who better, why they better, breaking down the lyrics, saying this is my nigga, but this nigga said XYZ. Then you had to wait a month or 2 months to get the fucking other side. Then you had to see what jabs niggas is throwing. Dog, that's what's missing. The block is missing on these niggas, bro.
Yeah,
we fuck.
I really
Lady Gaga won this beef.
I really hate getting my breakdown for some fucking nerd ass TikToker, YouTube fucking white boy who doesn't listen to real rap and probably scared to walk through a fucking hood. You're gonna tell me that this nigga won? He only won because you're comfortable with listening to his music and your mom allows it. I don't want to break down from you. Like, I don't. You, nigga, let's be honest. If we were still in the mixtape era, you probably wouldn't get your hands on beef tracks because they were in some hood on some corner store that you had to walk in this bitch and get it, except when LimeWire came around. But at one point in time, You had to go in the grimiest spot to get a beef, get a diss track. Because diss tracks wasn't made by the labels. It was made by these niggas out of their own pocket over an instrumental that they didn't have clearance for, that they had to drop on a Who Kid mixtape or a fucking Clue mixtape or DJ Big Mike mixtape. And you had to go to the hood to get these mixtapes.
They different
now, man. Y'all niggas feel comfortable y'all getting on YouTube in your crib. Like, I'm going to break it down.
An hour later.
Yes. And I just don't like it because it's like females, like when Beef came out, females used to like, I'm not listening. No disrespect to the females, unless she was a real hip hop hit. I'm not listening to some females saying like, oh, I think Jay won the beef. I'm like, wow. He's cute. Like, bitch, what? The fuck it?
That's what they were saying.
Bro, I seen females ride a nigga dick just because he was cute and was getting his ass handed to him in the beef. I'm like, I'm not listening to what you say. You ain't even listening to the lick. You just like the nigga because
she liked the beat. She liked the beat it was on.
It liked the beat, and that's one of her favorite.
I've heard that before.
Yes, I heard
somebody
it too.
Trying to say a song is better than another song because of the beat that is on.
But that's what niggas, that's the majority of why people like people now is because of that. Like, that's men, I want to say men, but to us, they're kids. Kids turned into that style of judging. You know what I'm saying? Like, judging music. It's, oh, because I like that person more, they won. Why? Yeah. Nah, man, that nigga fire. What else? Yo, man, you ain't hear CLB. You ain't hear this. You ain't hear that. Yo, that nigga. Nah, let's talk about lyrical ability. What did he say on this track that made you grimace for the other nigga and say, ooh? Or because the bars was so top tier, you said, oh, this nigga. Oh, he not playing with this nigga. So, you know what I'm saying?
You remember when Sorry Miss Jackson came out?
Oh, you talking about.
Oh, my God. I'm talking about with Kissing and Kiss. Styles P. Sorry Miss.
I like Checkmate more, but go ahead.
When Sorry Miss Jackson came out, I'm listening to that shit like, yo, Fifth, leave these niggas alone. Like, nah, it's
Checkmate
over.
Checkmate did it for me, bro. Checkmate did it for me, dog.
I'm like, it's over. There's nothing you can say with these niggas. These niggas is killing you right now. You are trying, like, it's good. You're riding the beef, but you're riding these little white kids that like G-Unit and shit like that, because it was a little, I'm sorry. I don't care. Y'all can get, Mary, y'all get mad at me. But it's certain white kids in the hood that they certify. And then there's you other motherfuckers is like, just stop. Like, you look ridiculous. You look like Malibu Most Wanted, nigga. I'm not taking nothing you say from me serious. Like,
that's America now, bro.
I'm just, and that's facts. But when I heard Sorry Miss Jackson, I'm like, and I'm a 50 fan, I'm like, Fifth, that's over. These niggas is telling that you are fucking trying to squash this shit because they on Interscope. These niggas is killing you with the bars. You actually saying you're stopping these niggas shit from coming out. These niggas is just throwing darts. Leave them, just let it go. Just let it go. I was listening, you know, another beef I was listening to. It's an old school beef. No Vaseline, Ice Cube.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my gosh.
It's common, right?
I went back and listened to that shit. I'm like, yo, I see. No Vaseline was to NWA.
Okay, right. You're right.
He dissed Common too, but No Vaseline was a direct diss to NWA. I listened to that shit. I'm like, oh, my God. That was a diss. He's name dropping. Not only he saying your name direct, but he's saying the fuck shit that you did and it's fucking, you know what I mean? Like, it's bad. It's like information to back this shit up. It's like, yo, I'm like, stop. You just annihilated y'all niggas. Them niggas tried to come back with a diss track, but they was already murdered off of Vaseline.
And yeah, because Cube didn't write it. He didn't write their comeback.
Yeah, so they couldn't come as hard as him because he's not writing any shit.
That's literally what that was.
Yeah. Do you think these new beefs with Drake and Ross are gonna be as good as the beefs that we used to listen to back in the day? You think they're gonna hit as hard? You know what I mean? Even without the internet shit, you're like, when we were listening to these shits recently, we were debating with each other, you know, through group messaging. You think that they're going to have the same effect on people? And how do you think it's going to go? You think their relationships are going to stay the same? You know what I mean? You think it's going to turn out like Nas and JG, or is it just going to be done?
They already started unfollowing each other on social media.
Yeah, that was a thing. The relationship was already fractured with a couple of these guys. I think the Kendrick and Drake shit was more lyrical. Like, I'm going to throw shots at you because XYZ. You know what I'm saying? They kept throwing shots back and forth at each other. But the Ross and Drake shit, been a dub for a while. And
it's just cool.
I'll answer your question in a bit.
No, I don't know. I really can't, because it's just... If the social media stays out of it and these niggas don't go on social media, if they stay off of social media trying to justify their case for beating these niggas in the rap competition, then it'll hold its weight. But as soon as they go on social media and all this shit, I'm done. I don't even want to listen to it no more, because it's like, this shit is whack. Like, put this shit on a mixtape and let me judge it. You know what I'm saying?
They're not going to do any of that, bro. They're not going to put anything on whatever a mixtape is that you're referring to. They're not going to get on social media, because they don't get on. Drake doesn't get on social media and talk to anybody. Drake does female shit and put like little shots on social media that only like niggas got to decipher it. Like, if he saw you and Diddy somewhere, he'll put some old cryptic shit up in a story that goes away in 24 hours. Oh, niggas want to talk shit like they Liddy, but I saw them in the bathtub with, and he won't put no word there. Like, he do weird shit. That,
what about that last shit he did?
I don't know. I ain't see him do that.
Well, with the text messaging with his mom.
Well, whose mom? Kendrick's mom?
No. When Drake put up a reaction to the whole nose job claim with that Rick Ross had on the disc, you know what I mean? And his Instagram story, and I guess it was like a screenshot of a text conversation with his mom's, and his mom's was saying, she was talking to him saying like the internet was saying he got a nose job. She said, "You look the same to me in the kitchen today." And then she said, "I can't believe you would get one without me, because you know I always wanted one. Don't tell me you got tattoos without me, and now this too." And then Drake responded to her with a bunch of like happy emojis, and then he said, "I would have got us a 2-for-1 deal if I went, Ma." And then he tagged Rick Ross in it, the Rich Forever account, and included the words, "You're one nosy goof."
He lost. He didn't tag him. I'm gonna tell you why he didn't lose.
Now, yes, that was some shit. That was some weak sauce shit. He tagged him and he said, "You're one nosy goof," means, "Oh, I'm with the shits." That's why I say, like, I was going to say, "All right, you losing." But number one, that diss was too hard for him to be losing, bro. Sorry. If you don't think that diss was hard, you're definitely biased. That diss was fucking hard, nigga.
The diss, yes. But doing that goofy shit after the fact's like, yo.
Yo.
You're one nosy goof?
Yo, he said, he told his mom, "It's coming from Rick Ross, the guy I did songs with. He's gone loopy the Manjaro. He hasn't eaten in days, and it's turned him angry and racist. He's performing at proms for money. It's bad. Don't worry, we'll handle it." Hey, yo, that's funny as...
Hey, Kev, nah, bro, that's witty. That's how he plays. That's funny as hell. That's how this nigga play. You can't play games with this man. He's basically almost a female. You can't play games with him. The man, devil has gifted this man with some because God. I'm sorry. Because you can't dodge, you can't shoulder roll that many things and still be good. This nigga's good, bro. That was witty.
He's not good, man. He type of nigga.
You biased, bro. Come on,
he's type of nigga. Yo, he's the type of nigga you got beef with, and you catch this nigga and punch him in his fucking mouth. And the cops is chasing. No, I ain't talking about fight. I listen to me when I'm. Let me finish my fucking sentence. God damn
go ahead.
It.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
He's the type of nigga that you will have beef with, punch in the fucking mouth when you see him, because he's talking gangster. And soon as you pull out the fucking parking lot, the cops is on your ass that this nigga just called.
What the fuck that got to do
with this nigga? Because he's a whole rapping his ass nigga.
Kev, what does that have to do with this nigga rapping his ass off? And then when you try to diss him, dog, the shit was funny. And it basically like, this nigga not a threat here. Like, that's, I'm sorry, that's clever in this.
He got y'all. See, he hooked y'all.
Clever. That's, no, that's clever.
Right,
hey,
so,
mom, this is the guy I was doing.
Yo. Hey, mom.
First of Rick Ross, Rose as the guy I did songs with.
So
it's the same thing. Hold on, hold on. It's the same thing as him saying, white boy, you do. It's the same thing.
Yo,
no, so Beans did that all shit, right. You be laughing?
Bro, that ain't Beans, but Kiss would do some funny shit like that, like go to a nigga. That's the same thing as going to a nigga block. So you want to take it to the back in the days. That's the same thing as going to a nigga block and saying, yo, he be out here. He be out here. That's this era's version of that. The shit was funny, nigga. The shit was clever and funny. This is the guy I did. He's probably hungry, dog.
I get it. I guess. I
you
guess
know Rick Ross trying to lose weight. Come on, bro.
I know clever he's trying to lose weight, but dog, he could have put that shit in the. He could have put that shit in a song.
He did.
I'm sorry. I'm done. I just can't fuck with you, nigga.
Yeah, you biased.
I can't.
You're so biased.
I can't, man.
I would probably beat Drake's ass.
I'm not biased because Drake said that while he's putting fucking barrettes in his hair. I'm not listening to
Yeah, because that's not biased.
Nigga don't wear barrettes.
It does. What does that have to
do with the nigga not wear barrettes and paint his fingernails?
Kev, I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying. Was the diss hard?
Gosh, bro.
Was it this hard?
This was hard. But now that you did this shit, it's like I see.
Oh, that
why
mean it's not hard no more.
I see why you. I see why Jay Prince stepped in for Pusha T, because Pusha T was ready to fucking.
Kev, you got to get some facts when you got to get some facts sometimes.
Pusha T wasn't going to annihilate fucking Drake because
we
did.
Said that, but we said that, but we're talking about Ross. Yeah. We're talking about Ross and Drake and the fact
so
that
now
that
Ross, who's not
hard.
A social media fucking
never said
dude,
he lost.
Who's not a social media dude, got to put bars out and then be funny on social media. Come, I wouldn't want to battle a nigga like this. You're right. He is a fucking
battle,
female.
You want to battle Rakim?
He's a straight. He's a fucking female, dog. He's a female. It's like arguing
Melly
with
Mel.
A fucking chick. You're not going to win. Somehow you're going to look like a fucking bad guy in a situation because you arguing with a chick. People with Drake is like arguing with a chick because this nigga is soft like a bitch. You're not going to win. This nigga got bitch tendencies.
Yo, wait.
And you're not going to win because the nigga will act like a whole ass nigga. And you can't beat a chick in an argument. I'm sorry.
Let me ask you.
Every nigga in America lost to a chicken argument.
Let's go back
to history.
Let's go back to 2004 and niggas start dissing each other. And then one dude gets on Smack DVD, goes to a nigga block and say, yo, where John John at? Oh, he'll never be out here. Hold on. He'll never be out here. Yeah, because I'm a real street nigga. But the other nigga, he just rapping because, yo, I'm better at rapping than you, and I'm going to show you. And he don't do that. You feel the same way?
Oh, well, Drake ain't going to Ross Hood.
All right, never mind. I don't think you understand.
Yeah, but why does it have to be anything gangster?
I'm sorry, because
if they're just
better at rapping.
Yeah, they're fighting lyrically. They're not fighting physically. You know what I'm saying? So what? See, that's the problem. That's the problem with you.
Drake, you want
that shit to turn into a boxing
y'all two ass niggas. Drake just fucking hit y'all with his devil fucking magic. Oh man, fuck out of here. I'm not listening to that shit. That nigga's a fucking hoe. That's some hoe ass shit. Like I don't hear nothing this nigga I put out no more. Just keep playing on social media. Don't rap.
That was funny.
Drake, you will win the beef just being on social media, nigga. Because you got niggas like these two niggas already loving it.
Well, let me ask you before we get out of here, nope. Do you think that Ross's jab was better than Drake's diss?
Yo.
Because lyrically, I wouldn't agree.
Drake, it's like, all right, Ross, respond to this shit now. It's like, that's why I'm at. Like, oh, Drake came for you, nigga. Respond to this shit. I'm sitting back waiting for the response. But in the meantime, let me text my mother about this guy that I'm beefing with.
That's that funny.
Nigga, go ahead with your fucking Degrassi bullshit. Like, I don't even want to hear that shit. You're right. You can't say no fuck. Don't Drake in your next diss. Don't mention a gun. Don't mention any street shit. Please just don't. Just be Drake. And I respect that. Because you text your mom in the middle of beef about a fat nigga. I'm sorry. Do that. I respect you, nigga. I respect you. If you don't say anything, don't talk about shooters you got. I don't care. They're imaginary. You pay for these niggas. Real shit. If your money ran dry, these niggas will rob you and beat you the fuck up. Like, you probably feel nervous. You probably felt nervous the first couple of times you was around some real street niggas.
That's what Ross said.
He did. He does. Now you're comfortable with him because you got enough money to keep the sharks up off your ass, nigga. I'm sorry. I don't want to hear shit from Drake. This nigga hit y'all with a devil magic, nigga. Like, y'all niggas is on that. Oh, it's funny.
Kev, because it was. And clever when you're beefing. It's like a nigga sending screenshots to you. Like, so I get it. To me, I don't like niggas weaponizing their fans. That, to me, that shit is weird. I don't want to hear another man saying Drake won and this is why, because he fire and he got this song, he got that song, and nothing that got to do with rap. To me, the diss was good. It was very good. It's what I wanted to hear from Drake. The nigga is talented. To me, him saying that shit is something funny, but it doesn't take away from that diss being good. The shit he did online, what Kev just read me, the shit is funny, nigga.
That shit is fucking hilarious.
The shit is funny. And imagine somebody putting out a screenshot because you tried to get with their baby mom and their baby mom curved you with some shit. It's the same shit. It's like, all right, you saying you fuck my baby mom? Here, let me put out the screenshots. And so you know what I mean? So we can say that it's a lie. Like, now I'm disproving the shit you saying and get this. Like, it's a game, bro. But I don't take away from that this being hard.
Didn't Drake had like a small beef with Luke, and nigga had to get up out of Miami. I could have swore it was like Luke said Drake just come to his city just to
fuck bitches probably.
Yeah, yeah, and Drake came back Drake said some shit, and then I think he got chased up out of Miami.
Good ass. Like,
and niggas know Luke is a real nigga. Like, Luke is that nigga. I you want to hear from Officer Ricky, bro? I don't care about hearing from Officer Ricky. I don't want to hear no Drake groupies that fucking watch this nigga meet on the internet telling me that Drake won.
Yeah, that's a crazy. Yeah, he should knock a couple points should be knocked off for the meat shit. That was some weirdo shit.
I'm saying, if y'all niggas watch that video, y'all are not allowed to comment on this beef. Mm-hmm. If you search for that video and you're a man, you can't comment on this beef. I'm sorry, you already excluded yourself.
What would you type in? Like, that's the craziest shit in the world to me. Yo, imagine the sentence that you would have to type in to find that video.
And you sitting there watching the video and your girl looks at your phone and you see this nigga stroking his meat. You can't say nothing about this beef. If you watch that video and you was a dude, you're excluded from this beef. I'm sorry. Yeah, I want to hear nothing. You got to say you've seen Drake meat. So you already fucking one of his boy fans.
That's a good point. What if Ross had to watch it for his research?
Ross, if you watch that shit for your research, you're done too. You lost. I get a dub to Drake. You lost because you man. You should not be looking at this nigga meat.
Hey, your shit ain't even juicy, nigga. Nigga, I seen bigger dicks than another nigga.
I'm like, what?
Hey, yo.
You ain't the boss.
You ain't the boss.
Like, nigga, like, you like,
I seen the video, nigga.
Oh, what man. Video? Like, what video, Ross? What video did you see, Ross?
Don't worry about it, white boy. Video.
White boy. Like, you ain't even circumcised. I don't know.
All right, yo. Ross, say that shit, nigga. He lost.
It's like, he lost.
Every battle.
Take an L. Take an L. You done. You got some, you go sit over there in the corner with your other artists. You sit with me. You and Meek done took an L from Drake. Both of y'all niggas.
You lost the battle with heterosexualness. Nah, man, niggas gonna leave my nigga Meek alone though, bro. We gonna stop. I'm gonna tell you one thing, and we gonna end this shit. Meek, get off Twitter, bro. Just get off Twitter. Stop. Just leave Twitter alone. You know you mad because Wale took a picture with somebody. Yo, y'all niggas got it. So I have a problem with men who do female things, and not because I'm the manliest of men. But to me, when you do like emotional ass weird shit, I like it's just I don't like that. Like I don't like a man who called me too much. I don't like none of that shit. Like you get what I'm saying? Like a needy ass man. That's nothing worse to me than a needy man. So I say that because there's Meek got mad at Wale because Wale took a picture with Dean. Dean was on Dream Chasers, but he's like he going around dissing Meek, like he got a problem with Meek. And Meek get online and start talking about it. It's like, bro, that ain't. I know you. And I fuck with Meek. I know you a real nigga and all that shit. I know you a real nigga and all that shit. But real niggas don't. Come on, that's weird. Get on social media,
especially if you got the nigga number.
Diss track. But y'all just said
Drake was cool for weirdo shit.
You y'all just said Drake was cool for going on social media.
Nah, nigga, that was clever and funny. This is weird. If Meek was
y'all
into
niggas
it
watch
with,
the Drake Meek video, because that's what it seems like.
If Meek was into it with Drake and then Meek said some funny shit that was relevant, funny is funny. Funny is funny. The nigga is funny, bro. That shit was funny.
He's not funny. He's a female. He's a fucking he's a female. Female
argument,
say
okay.
Females say the most wittiest shit that a nigga can't come back off of. You just like, you little bitch call you dusty and dirty, grimy, little ugly, black ass nigga. You have no comeback for that shit.
It's not what Drake did, but
he did this. Kev,
I think you're drunk because the two don't.
He just called the nigga fat and he trying to.
He responded. He responded to shit that Ross said about him.
Throw it on the track, nigga. Put it on the track.
He did. And it was still good.
And Ross didn't rap about the shit. He just literally, after the song was over, had a conversation. That ain't no different than putting it on social media.
But it was good. The point is that this independently was good, and the shit independently online is funny. That's why I don't get why you saying, oh, it's corny because he did one for the nigga. The diss was good. Ross diss was cool. It was a jab. The shit he was saying after, that's like him saying, that's like you saying, like, nah, that because he said all that shit afterwards, that the diss wasn't, you know what I'm saying? It's like, nah, it don't have to, those two don't have to really affect each other, but they do. You know what I'm saying? They don't have to affect each other. The diss was good independently, bro.
I think it was fair for him to say that, you know what I mean, to throw that on Instagram. You hear a song, nigga, drop a battle or drop a jab to you in a song, and then after the song, he just starts talking about shit, saying that you called the police, you got a nose job, white boy, this, that, a third. You know what I mean? Not even making raps about it. He just talking his shit, getting his shit off. You know what I mean? And then instead of you doing it on a track, you get your shit off on the internet, throwing a funny ass joke, a little jab back, and then letting everybody know at the same time, oh, don't worry, this next shit is coming. We'll handle it. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, leaves you in suspense. It's like leaving you in suspense.
Go to the radio station and then start talking. This is the version of going to the radio station and talking shit about the other nigga. Like, me, he's a pussy. I never see him out. He'll never come to the club. He'll never stay out. It's the same shit, just now. It's the same shit, bro. It's just not 100% street. When you see him, he'll punch him in the face. It's not that, because he won't.
What's that song, Drake
had? He's keeping it real.
Oh, how'd that shit go? What was one of Drake's songs, like one of his songs that like was popular on the radio?
I got a feeling you look one up and you got one ready.
Nah, I can't think about it. It's a lot of Drake. Them. Drake just sang it. What name one Hotline of Drake Bling. Sang it as?
I hate that song, Hotline Bling. I hated that fucking song.
Nah, it's name something better.
I hated it.
Name one of his summertime.
I better find your loving. I hated that song too. Anything that that's singing.
What's playing in y'all two niggas' heads is y'all fucking dick riding Drake right now.
As I said, I hate the song. That's a pretty good job. What about Stay Scheming?
No, y'all niggas is hearing. Y'all niggas is hearing R&B songs as y'all fucking riding Drake right now. That shit was.
Yeah.
You just. What does that mean that you me riding Ross?
Whatever.
No, I'm you just sound like a hater. Like, you sound like a biased. You sound like a biased man.
He's always been biased to Drake. Remember,
you're a biased man.
He's always been biased to Drake. Ever since he first said he wanted to box Drake years ago.
Yeah,
I never wanted to box that nigga. Yeah. Y'all niggas said I wanted to box this nigga. Box this nigga. I don't give a fuck about that. I don't know this nigga. Never met this nigga.
Sounds like you did.
And, said him and Nick Cannon.
Sounds like you vividly. Did meet him, and you had your preconceived notions.
Oh, I have.
Did he ink you?
I don't care about. He's another light skin, another soft ass light skin nigga. I ain't got.
Okay, what does skin color have? I'm tired of y'all niggas saying light skin and soft and all this shit. I hear a lot of that down here.
Care, man. He's a fucking Degrassi. I don't care about a nigga I seen on Degrassi. I remember this nigga started rapping, and I first seen this nigga. I was like, yo, that's the same nigga my little female cousins was watching on TV at 14, all in love with the nigga in the wheelchair.
What does that have to do with his rapping ability?
He doesn't have none because he got a fucking ghostwriter.
That's not true. That's not true, Kev. You're biased. And that makes him not the best rapper. That doesn't make him a good rapper
because it's all right to have a ghostwriter, man. I'm sorry. I don't give a fuck about Drake, man. I don't. Like, he's a fucking heartthrob for every little fucking teeny bopper out there.
You realize that throws your credibility away when talking about this beef. That's
I don't care. Take my credibility away from this nigga. I don't care. I'm not listening to a nigga who walks around with Brett's in his hair at a basketball game on the sideline. Hey, man, come on. I'm not getting into it.
Was it this hard?
Nope. It was a hard diss, but
all right, let's end this. Let's end this.
Y'all niggas called me about this shit on social media. I don't want it. All right, yeah, I've been slapped my mic away. I don't want to talk about this cornball ass nigga no more.
First you said it was hard, then you said it's not hard.
It's not hard because he came out with that. He's texting his mom, talking about, mom, I'm beefing with this fat guy on social media. Like, man, shut the fuck up. Like, throw a track out.
Shit was funny. He did, and it was good. That's the point.
Nigga, man,
you can
nigga
do that.
Nigga got bitch tendencies to me, dog. Every time y'all, the more and more he talks about this nigga, the more and more this nigga got bitch tendencies. I don't care. And he probably hear this say, so I fuck. No, you're not going to fuck me up. Now I got beef. You're not going to fuck me up. The niggas you pay off will fuck you up.
Just created money to.
The niggas you give money to.
Narrative against
the niggas you give money to will fuck me up. The niggas that are really dumb niggas that you give money to, dumb niggas will fuck me up.
We know Drake.
You, on the other hand, man, I'm sorry. Drake, you look like a nigga that never been in a fight. And if you did, Windmills was involved, nigga. I don't give a fuck.
Y'all niggas
was windmilling.
They said Puff smacked him to the ground.
Yeah. Drake looked like a nigga that windmilled in his day. He looked like he windmilled when he fight. That nigga looked like he was doing this. That nigga don't know how to throw a correct. That nigga didn't. He didn't know how to throw a correct punch until he started taking boxing training. That nigga was windmilling.
Oh my gosh.
That nigga's a wrestler. All that right. Nigga's one of them get you in a tussle and don't no punch to get thrown.
What's in this?
I ended. Y'all could have been ended it.
Drake.
That nigga probably got punched in his shit one time. Ain't even do nothing. Ain't even respond. Went home.
I just said that Puff slapped him. Puff slapped him to the ground. He ain't do nothing. That's what happened.
He ain't do nothing? Why?
I don't know.
You got the same amount of niggas that you can stick on Puff niggas.
Puff got a video with him.
And you can have a one-on-one with Puff. You bigger than Puff. But Puff's a real street nigga. See, with it, he's scared because he know he got knocked out by Puff.
So Puff got more street cred, even though he be fucking people in the ass.
Yo, the nigga from The Wire, Omar, was fucking a nigga, and he was a fucking street ass dude.
That's all right. That's
I'm just saying.
Let's make believe. Let's end this.
Oh, whatever. It's street niggas that are gay. That'll shoot you.
All right.
He's just scared he's gonna get knocked out by Puff and really get hit with a no diddy. Nigga backed out. He's gone.
What the hell the stream yard, nigga? I said, I did hit leave studio. I'm in hit end stream. Fuck.
End the shit. Peace out.